Hi, this is Roger Eastlick, and this is going to be a hands-on review of GoToMyPC, which is remote desktop remote control software for your PC. It allows you to remotely get into a PC from anywhere and look at what's on the desktop, share the desktop, transfer files to and from that remote machine. So in other words, it's another huge productivity tool and time saver when you're away from your home PC or your main work PC and you want to get into it. Features, just to go through that real quick, so you get remote access. You can connect to any computer from a Mac or a PC. You can also, in the easy installation, we'll see that in just a second. It's encrypted, so it's got 128-bit encryption, which I guess is pretty good. And mobile access, so you can actually get to your machines, you can actually access your machine, remote machine, from an iPad or iPhone or from an Android device. You've got copy and paste, you've got desktop shortcut, big deal, right? You've got remote printing, so you can print like on your home PC or on your work PC from wherever you are. File transfer, so you can transfer a file, like I said, transfer files back and forth. Individual usage reports, keyboard locking and screen blanking, so if you're not there and you want to work but you don't want other people like spying on what you're doing, you can, or kids at home pounding might come and pound on the keyboard, then you can lock the keyboard and blank the screen so nobody can see what's going on. Multi-monitor support, pretty common thing. A lot of people have two or more monitors now, or two monitors now. I've got two monitors. Sound, remote sound, which is really cool. It allows you to listen to stuff, video, the sound from videos or audio files on the remote device, whether it's your iPhone, iPad, Android phone, and you're connected to, for example, your home or your work PC. You can listen to videos and the audios from that. And then guest invite. So let's go ahead and install this. In order to install that, you would go ahead and first you'd sign up for the free trial if you haven't already. So let's see, that would be here, and you'd go through this, and it's going to ask you for your credit card and everything, but it is easy to uninstall and to cancel if you want to. I've canceled Citrix products before and actually gone back to them later on and had no problem whatsoever when I canceled. They actually, it's pretty cool, they don't cancel right away. They allow your subscription to run out if you're on a subscription or a free trial, and then they just don't renew. So it's pretty cool. You can safely try the software without having to worry about not being able to get out or some tricks or anything like that. They don't do that. My experience with Citrix has been really good. So let's see. Then you'd want to log in once you've gotten your credentials. Okay, we'll put our email address in here. We can. Password, hopefully. See if this works. Welcome back. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and click on the Yes, Install, go to my PC. Whoops, looks like we're going to put Java on there. We'll be right back. Okay, so it looks like what happened was I successfully installed Java And now it is completing the installation of GoToMyPC. And so you need to click on the download button. Keep it. It's like 20 seconds for the download. And then go to the install. There we go. Click on yes. Next. This seems to be going happen this happening pretty fast. I'm using a virtual machine, a VMware machine, virtual machine inside of my computer, so it should be a little bit faster on a regular computer. Time I upgrade my computer anyway, I guess. All right, looks like it's finished. Looks like it wants my account information again. It lets me log in. Nickname for this computer. Tests. How about that? Create an access code for this computer. Account password is stored only on this computer, known only to you. Okay, so I don't know. I'm not sure if I really need to do this or not. I mean, I don't think you need to see this. So I'm going to put in an access code. I'm going to confirm the access code and pause the screen. Put in those two things and then click OK. So let's do that. Okay, I clicked OK on that. I guess I could have left it there because it was all dotted out in the first place. But anyway, let's see. No, let's see. Internet Explorer, my default browser. Okay, I guess if I have to. Helper, enable. I guess. Anyway. Now what? All right, so now we're good to go. Should be good to go. Let's try to go to my main machine. This is my main machine. I'm going to go to here though. I'm going to use, oh, that's not my main machine. Wait. Get rid of this. Bring over a browser. Momentarily. Waiting for Google Chrome to start up here. It's going to, I don't know, maybe not. Here we go. There we go. Bring it over to this screen. Alright, how about if we go to my PC? Probably need to log in, but I've got an answer for that. I should just be able to use my GoTo RoboForm. RoboForm. We go. Let's see if we can save this. Oh well. Ah, there we go. That's what I wanted right there. All right, so Here we are right here. Test to go to my PC. Connect. So I'm going to go ahead and connect. Looks like it says if you have download problems, you can actually use a universal viewer, which works from a public internet terminal, which is pretty cool. And like I say, in fairness, to the speed of GoToMyPC, I'm using it just on a virtual machine, so I think that I'm quite sure it would run a little bit faster than this. Because for some reason my virtual machine is notoriously slow until I get my new PC. So launch successful. Says if it doesn't start within a minute, you're supposed to manually download it. I am going to go ahead and manually download this. Let's see, here we go. Progress. Turn to my computers. In session. Connect. Oh, actually, on the other screen, I've got this right here. Initializing your connection. That was that passcode that you needed to set up. Plug that in there and oops. This, my friends, is what you see. This up here, as you can see, it's pretty cool. It's a nice cool green screen. Test it shows you, and this is my remote, looking at my remote machine, which I kind of messed up a little bit. So here's this. I'm in my remote machine now. So I can get rid of this window if I want to. Click around here. See, you can see where I installed the Java on that remote machine. So I don't really have a whole lot of applications on this remote machine. It's basically got some... it's got a few things in it. Not too much. But as you can see, it's pretty fast, moving around. You got some tools. See what happens if I want to. See, I can go and set it to a printer if I wanted to. I don't have anything. I don't have any files or anything on here, I don't think. I won't do that because I don't think it'll work very well. So it looks like I could... here is how it looks like I could do, this is pretty cool. This is how I can transfer files back and forth. Looks like this is from my client machine where I am. This is the remote here. I don't really have any files out there. Let's say I did want to do something out there. What I got? I have a Liberty Mutual file I could transfer over there. Boom. It's gone. Done. No problem. I could delete that if I wanted to. It's a PDF file. So that's pretty slick. I actually like this better than this. I like better than Log Me In. Anyway, we're running up against the time. This was an install and a little bit of a review of GoToMyPC. Gives you an idea of how easy it is to install. I am pretty impressed. This is Roger Eastlick. You can click on the link below to get a free trial of GoToMyPC. Try it out for 30 days absolutely free. I think they ask you for a credit card, but don't worry, it's easy to cancel if you need to. But it's a very nice software. Thanks for watching.